Hope you guys are doing great, and so am I. And if you're new to this channel, my name is Deep Kataria, and I'm a first year engineering student who is pursuing computer science. Well, one of the questions that I often get asked by a lot of my friends is the fact that how the hell am I even able to make like 3 videos a week? Even though I started out like 3 months ago and I haven't really had a massive success till yet, and if you know what I'm talking about. But when I'm talking to my friends, they know it, and I also know it, that making 3 videos a week as a full-time engineering student is not easy at all. So my approach for maintaining like this YouTube channel and creating 3 videos a week, which is pretty much necessary for the long-term growth of this channel, what I've really done is I have created like a full-blown system for creating videos, so I'm able to churn out one video after the other and just so on and so forth. And this idea of creating a system came from the book Atomic Habits by James Clear, which, by the way, I've reviewed on this channel. In case you're interested, I'll link it up in here and also down in the description. When you have successfully created a system, what really happens is, of course, you're able to get that thing done, but your subconscious mind doesn't really have to work, because that really is a part of your habit. It's just like typing on a keyboard, because when you type on a regular basis, you know exactly where the keys are and you can just hit those keystrokes flawlessly. But if you don't know how to type, you'll be looking for that key. Oh, where's A? Where's this letter? Where's that letter? And you'll be pretty much confused all the time. Just in a similar fashion, I've created a system for myself. So I have to do only the doing part, like typing. For example, I took the example of the keyboard. So I don't have to freak out every week and think like, hey man, I just have to make like 3 videos this week. It's rather like, heck yeah, there are 3 videos that I have to make and I'm so excited. So the app that I use for creating a system for myself goes by the name of Notion. And if you have been here on this channel, I've mentioned about Notion, I think a couple of times, I think multiple times at this point. And in case you don't know what Notion is, it is basically like a database management software. And how it works like is, it has like a bunch of pages, and inside of those pages, you can write a bunch of stuff. And also you have like a different set of tools, I should say a range of tools. And using those inbuilt tools, you can create like a full blown database for yourself. So here's how I've done that. And here's how it looks like. So once you jump inside of Notion, this is how my page really looks like. So I have this page which goes by the name of content creation. Up on the top, I have a quote. This is how I usually like things, if you know what I mean. You can change it right where it says change cover. You can change anything, make it a single color, a gradient. You can also choose pictures from unsplash.com. Just, you know, type, let's say you want camera, for example. You have like different set of images of camera that will pop up on the screen. So this is how you can change it. But jumping on to the main thing, the main contents of the page, how they really look like. So here I have my YouTube page, which I'll be taking you in a second. Then I have for other platforms, Instagram and Twitter. I have like different set of ideas that I've planned for Instagram and Twitter. There are a couple of them, but I'm not like executing them right now because I don't have a lot of time. I have my majors coming in next month, so I have to plan accordingly. Then I have this heading of content calendar, and here I have the link database, which I'll be taking you in a second, of YouTube videos. And here I see all of my videos that I'll be working on in like the next month, in the next 30 days. So at the bottom, I have a resources page. Here I have a couple of resources, for example, you know, After Effects expressions, in case you have done After Effects animations, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Then there are a couple of future ideas, intro, outro, you know, what kind of colors I use with their RGB value, and a bunch of that kind of stuff. So once you step inside of this YouTube page, I mean, first I'll take you to the table view. You know, inside of this table view, you can make like different set of entries, and I basically have few columns. The obvious one is of name, then time blocking. Time blocking means the specific time in which I would like to get this video done. Then I have this date on which I would be uploading this video. That means on the particular day when it will be going live. Then I have the status. The status is of different categories, and I'll explain the meaning of every single one of them and why I have set out different categories for all of this. So starting with idea, started, scripting, writing in progress, script ready, ready to film, A-roll film, all the way to publish. Right now, this video has been published. Here I have the genre of the video, on which specific genre it will be falling. So I have all of these like series that I'll be working on. Monday's book review, you're already familiar with that. Then book recommendations, I'll be starting the series in a while. Then I have all sorts of series. I mean, there's a bunch of future ideas. You pretty much saw it. There's nothing to hide as such, but like all the series that I'll be doing right now, at this particular point, I'm only doing like 2 or 3 series. So I don't think it really has like a huge importance. And then I have this archive of uploaded videos. It's just a page where I dump all of the videos that are done. So I can just, you know, declutter this page and things are clean overall. So for example, these 3 videos are done. So what I'll do is I'll click on this, you know, then I'll press shift and the downwards arrow key, then I'll select all three of them and this dump them straight away into this uploaded videos folder. So this is the table view. This is the basic one. I usually don't use it. I just told you and explained you so you can understand the framework of this database and how the things really work. And I also have this sorting parameter, which tells me the date in ascending order, because I want to see the videos that are to be uploaded first at the very top. Then the status, the progress of the video that I've made so far. And then there's the name of ascending descending order, because sometimes, you know, I have same date for different sort of videos, so I want to see them in like a specific order in that case. So that's how it goes. Then I have, you know, the board view. The board view is the one that I use almost all the time, like literally almost all the time. I'll be talking about this board view in a second, because there's a bunch of things happening inside of that and I'll be explaining that in a second. So first I'll take you through this calendar view. The calendar view is pretty simple. I mean, you can look at all of the video. You can have like a bird's eye view at the entire month, and once you go to this, you know, open as a page, you can look at all the videos that I'll be working on. I mean I have planned the videos till like August 13. I mean, a rough idea, not exactly how it will be going, but I have videos figured out till like August. And not to mention, there are about 250 videos, as you guys can check, that have no date assigned, at least as of now. So I have a couple of ideas, and because of this database only, I have like this creative workflow that helps me do all of this, and here's how I do it. So the reason why I have so many ideas inside of this database that like protects me from creator block, imposter syndrome, all those kind of things, is because I have this database that helps me with like a creative workflow to manage all these things. And once I take you inside of the board view, which I'll be taking you in a second, first we will be going through the timeline view. So the timeline view is basically for like looking at things in the way of a timeline. What I really use it for is, you know, blocking time, but I'm not really doing that at this point, because the projects that I was working on, I can't work on them anymore, because in New Delhi we have a lockdown for more than a month at this point. So a lot of projects has been delayed, but because I have a database that is set in, I could just like change the dates and mess with everything at like a really fast pace. Otherwise, you know, if things went wrong, I would be like upset for like 15 days and I would make no progress. But because I have a database like this, it makes things very easy. So finally, I'll be taking you through the board view, and this is where I spend most of my time. So my creative process really starts with no status, where I, you know, dump a bunch of ideas, you know, brainstorm them. Then when I realize that, hey, this is actually an idea which I can make a video about, then this thing, for example, let's say I wanted to make this video for a while, and you know, I watched every single Mr. Beast video and here's what I learned. I'm pretty excited about this video. So let's say right now it's in no status. I have like no idea when I'll be filming it, when I'll be making it, but I think it will be an exciting video. So I'll take this to idea, and you know, there are a bunch of things inside of that. You know, you have this YouTube video template. I'll be taking you through that in a second. But then once it's in the ideas, you know, board, you know, I have different sort of boards. So you know, when I want to script this video, I'll take this to start scripting. Then, you know, when I'll start writing this, the script for this specific video, then I'll take it to writing in progress. I think it just went all the way down. Yeah. So then I can take it into the script ready. Once the script is ready, then I can horizontally scroll it. And then when the script is finally done and it's ready to film, then I can take it to ready to film. Then when I film the A-roll meaning like the talking head, like I'm filming right now, then I'll take it to A-roll is film. Then the filming section, in case some videos like require a certain amount of B-roll and all those sorts of elements, then I'll take it to filming. Then when everything is filmed and the video is ready to edit, then I'll take it to the ready to edit section. And then editing takes like two or three steps. Usually for me, it takes two steps. First, when I dump all of the footage inside of my computer, and then I really start working and make a rough cut of that. Rough cut means the parts that I'll be using, because when I'm filming, you know, there's a bunch of pauses, there are a bunch of retakes, shots that I like, shots that I didn't like. And then I just dump it inside of the editing software and make a rough cut of all the things that I need to make that video. So then I'll take it to rough cut is ready, then I'll take it to edited once that is edited, and once that is ready to publish. Ready to publish means I am done with the video and thumbnail is made, everything is made. Then I put it to ready to publish, and according to the dates, I just, you know, put it to the published ones. For example, let's say you know, I've made everything, everything is done. And once everything is kind of like done, then what I really do is pick one of the videos from ready to publish. Usually it's planned which video is going. Then what I really do is write the description for a video, write the timestamps, and you know, mention the cards, the end screens, you know, a bunch of that kind of stuff. And also I have to make the thumbnail, which is super, super important in case you're making YouTube videos, and you know, a bunch of that kind of stuff. So, you know, I'll be taking it back into the, I think, and right inside of genre, it is regular upload. So I'll check that. And in case you guys would notice, it would be right here in the ideas section. And to search it right here, where it says search, I'll search Mr. Beast. Yeah, you know, here it is. Then click on it. And here's where almost all of the things happen. You know, I have these templates, and what these templates really do is, for example, let's say if I click on this YouTube video template, because it's not book review, book review has a certain like different element because the script of book review is pretty different from my regular video. So I've made a different template for that. But if I click on these three dots and right where it says edit, this is how the template really looks like. You know, if I click on it, open as a page, I mean, you can see that it has all of these contents, so I can edit that, do a bunch of stuff. But I'll be going back to YouTube videos, right? Then once I go back and, you know, I have to find this video again, Mr. Beast one, you know, I can click on this YouTube video template and it kind of like populates the entire space. Come on, I hate that word because I live in India with 1.4 billion people living on it. But anyway, it kind of like populates the entire workspace, and you know, I have all of these things. It just provides me this like creative workflow to get things done. And I have title ideas, so let's say, so I'll keep this title idea same. I watched every single Mr. Beast video. I watched every single Mr. Beast, I think Mr. Beast is spelled like this, then Mr. Beast video, and here's what I learned. So this is a title idea, and along the way, if I have different title ideas in my head, I'll write it up in here. Then the thumbnail ideas, the thumbnail would be, or something like that, you know, it just provides me with this workflow that I don't have to scratch my head every single time. I have like this Hives method that I learned from Ali Abdaal. What it says is basically you have a hook for a video, then you have the intro and the value that you're providing and the link to another video. For example, you know, what's the hook? Then I'll be saying this thing like the way Mr. Beast says. So I'll just copy this, you know, and then inside of the intro, you know, I usually do it with my the same regular intro that I have. For value, I'll be explaining all sorts of tricks that I've learned from him. The thumbnail, you know, because all of these things have an art to it, the way you write the thumbnail, the way you write the title, and like all of those things. So, you know, etc, etc. And then once I move to this link to another video, I don't know which video I'll be linking it to, but anyways, then I have the script. At this point, of course, I haven't done anything for that video, so I won't be showing you through the script. But in case you're interested, I have made a video about how I script inside of Notion, which I'll be linking it up in here and also down in the description, and you can watch that video. I have literally explained how I script, and it's a 25-30 minute video where I script with like no cuts at all, so you can see my workflow and how I script. But anyways, once I'm kind of like done with the scripting part, what I usually do is I go to the tags and figure out what category of the tags that it will fit in. For example, let's say, you know, I'll type Mr. Beast only right here, and then I'll type YouTube growth, something like that, you know, YouTuber. In this video, I don't have any sort of like crazy tags as such, but here I just type all the tags and like the category of the video that it will fit in. So the music, I pretty much like decide the music beforehand, so as a creator, it doesn't stop me. So once I'm like filming the video, editing it, I don't have to like browse through hundreds of music and figure out what's copyright free, royalty free, and check the licenses, all of that kind of stuff. Because as a creator, I just want to go smoothly without any breaks, because if I stop over and over again, it doesn't work for me. So as music is done, and then sponsored content, I mean, there's no way I'm getting any sponsored content at this point, but it is future proofing the template. So I have this non-sponsored content, of course, because nobody sponsored me at this point. So I'll add description, a few sentences about the video, timestamps, tags, include credits, end cards, cards, and video to a suitable genre, you know, the playlist in which I add the video, then schedule the video at 7:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time, all that kind of stuff. And then once the video is being being published, then I have to do the post-publishing, that answering a few comments and share it to Instagram and, you know, share it to Twitter and a bunch of that kind of stuff. And this is how I pretty much do it. And this is pretty much how I make YouTube videos. I mean, without this template, it would be impossible for me to make 3 videos a week. I'm only able to make 3 videos a week because I have this template, and it is absolutely amazing. And in case you are interested in how I made this template, I'll be making like a full course on that, which will be absolutely available for free. So in case you are interested in that, make sure you're subscribed. So that's it from my side. If you made it this far, make sure you guys like the video. That tells me that you're full of energy and you're pumped. And thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next one.